Tracy here. Welcome back to Code to Create. While I was away, I actually traveled to different places and spoke at different conferences and ran my own conference as well. I ran AndroidTO a bit late last year, and in between, I ran different workshops and meetups. Actually, I started in-person events before I joined this YouTube thing. Today, I will show you things I learned from running meetups and actually what it takes to run a consistently high quality meetups. I'm based in Toronto. When I just started my career, there were just very few events that focused on my area. In today, 2019, there are just so many meetups going on. And on the same day, there are at least like three meetups focusing on similar areas and in the similar neighborhood. So first, when you think about it, do we really need to have another meetup? Or should we just be part of another group? We can actually together get more volume of attendees and speakers instead of we spread out. Initially, we actually joined another meetup. It was called GTalk. Google Hangout was calling GTalk, and they had difficult time to continue the organization, and they need someone else to carry it over. Of course, we should totally collaborate because they already have existing members, and they already have established brand and established relationship. That's how this whole GTalk thing carried on, become today's GDG Toronto, like Google Developer Group Toronto. So first of all, before even thinking of having your own group starting from the ground, why not to collaborate or even just join another groups? And we really need to put down our pride first, because running a meetup is really like a job, which is like my second point. Running a meetup is like a job. At first come of meetups, it will be always fresh, exciting. But again, running a meetup is very different than running a huge conference, because a conference has an end. At least it's only once a year, but running a meetup, we need to do it regularly, and there are just so many little things we need to do. Location, speakers, and timing, and also housekeeping, and billing, refunding, social media. It's just so much work involved in running a meetup. It's constantly going on, so it's actually never having an end. It's great to have a team. So doing it alone, it's very frustrating. A lot of people could do it by themselves. Maybe eventually they could hire other people to do it. But again, running a meetup, it is a job. Maybe you never get paid to do it, but the volume of work is high. So third is the biggest struggle of all the meetups is to finding great content. Yes, finding great content is extremely difficult. I attended multiple community dinners in Toronto, and another one was in Los Angeles. Even though we are from different countries and different cities, and we all ran into the same problem, was actually finding quality speakers, or even not even quality speakers, just constantly having good content. It's very difficult finding different organizers, so we can spread out the stress of finding good content regularly. And number four is, since it's so hard to find good content, it's really hard to keep your attendee focused. If it's a free meetup, usually you are expecting like 30% of people not gonna show up. However, this data may be different in different cities. I have seen some of my friends, their meetups can run up to 200 people and they always show up. So yeah, I feel very jealous. But on average, you expecting about 30 to 60 people in like a city in North America. A lot of people are not going to show up if it's a free event. So you maybe consider to charge your event. However, when you start charging for events, you need to provide value back to the attendees. So you're not going to say, we're just going to hang out, but I'm going to charge you money for it. And just keep in mind that there will be refund, right? People will ask you for a refund. Are you really willing to put up the work to refund them $5? It's a lot of work, again, related to my previous point. So last but not least, of course, there are good things coming up from running meetups. As I mentioned, I start running meetups and speaking at events at an early stage of my career. It really helped me building up my networks and really gain my knowledge. Also gave me information about where the industry was going. I was initially started as a Flash developer, and I constantly learning. And I realized the limitation of Flash at that point, and also the industry trend, like Flash was just not gonna last. So I actually discovered Unity. I went to all the meetups and all the conferences about Unity. Now I'm actually have become an experienced Unity developer. I started working on Unity even when it was just coming out as a very new game engine. So of course, running meetups is really beneficial for our career, especially at early stage of our career. Again, I mentioned it's really helpful at early stage. At a later stage, I actually do find speaking at a conference is way easier and way more beneficial. It's kind of unfortunate that you're never going to get recognized as an event organizer, because the spotlight is never on the organizers. It's always on the speakers. However, if you don't really want to give talks, you don't really want to be the front-facing person, it's a great way to network with influenced people in the community. So running meetups is still very fun, a great way to boost up your career and making networks, meeting friends, and also feel fulfilled because we are actually giving back to our community. Well, it's always good to see you back. I will see you in next video. Bye. Thanks for watching. Please click the subscribe button. And this will actually help me so much. And also, it's kind of a bookmark for you. You can find me easily. And for me, just by having a bigger subscriber base, I will actually get access to the YouTube studio, which will give me a better space to film my videos and gonna make my production so much easier. Thanks again. Have a good day.